Hey, Ronnie.
Hey, Lou.
Hey, look, I'm driving to Santa Cruz in a couple days. Can I borrow your map?
Yeah.
Got a map?
Sure.
A paper map?
Mm-hmm. Hmm.
You know, people like to think of the past as a simpler time. Back before GPS, dating apps, and the Googles, people had to live their lives without the ease and accessibility the internet allows us and affords us, which made the following 20 things or so way harder than they are now. So let's talk about, on this episode, Ron, things that were way harder before the interwebs.
Can't wait.
Next on Men Are So Smart. Well, hello again. I'm Lou Gallagher.
I'm Corvette Ronnie.
Welcome to Men Are So Smart. We're so glad to have you today. Thank you for your time. We hope you enjoy our show.
Yeah.
And, you know, there's so many things in the past that we used to do. Like when you had a book report that was due in school, it meant one of two things. You had to hope that whatever the title was of the story that you were going to do coincided with a Funkin' Wagnall encyclopedia letter that you had.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it was off to the library.
Or maybe you could find Cliff's notes.
Well, what's Cliff going to do if he doesn't have his notes?
Yes. Yeah.
Looking up information required flipping through what we called kids an encyclopedia.
Oh boy, they were brutal.
Google wasn't even founded until 1998. Before then, you had to manually find information in things we like to call books. And they had words. And words are hard.
Words are hard. Yeah. Okay, this next one. I find this ridiculous to even think about it anymore. Finding your way from point A to point B, relying on a physical map.
Yeah, or a Thomas guide. Remember those?
Oh, now I lived with a Thomas guide.
Yeah.
I got one every year through the sheriff's department. I probably have 27 of them somewhere. So I saw a TV show not too terrible long ago, and this older, and it is, it's about kind of bridging the gap between the ages, and this guy says, hands these couple of millennials a map, and the kid goes, when did Google start printing out their maps?
Oh, Lord.
So we went yesterday. I had to buy, I didn't have to, but I bought something off Facebook Marketplace. And so the people told me where they were. I'm like, I don't even care where you are. Just shoot me your address. Turns out they were about 1 mile from Poor Ed's. You remember that place?
Oh, sure. Yeah. It's been a while, but yeah.
Yeah. So it is funny, but again, I don't care where anybody's located anymore that I'm going to be able to find my way. I put it on Waze, my GPS. I can tell them what time I'm going to be there and if there's any traffic ahead of me.
Right.
No brainer.
Next up, dating wasn't a swiping game. Dating apps nowadays function as portable Rolodexes of potential dates. But before the internet, you either had your social network set up with a potential partner, or you approached people IRL, Ronnie. What does that mean? In real life.
Oh, yeah.
God forbid.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's crazy talk.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right. This next one. When you arranged a meeting with someone, you used to have to be punctual.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, you can just send a text, say, hey, I'm running 5 minutes late. And you know what? The person on the other end can just go to their phone and play Yahtzee or, you know, Candy Crush or something to take their time. I know when I go to a doctor's appointment, I'm sitting in a waiting room. That used to be the longest half hour of my life.
Yeah.
Sitting there with a bunch of people coughing and hacking.
Watching or looking at the doctor's office magazines.
Yes. Or they have some, like my doctor has a kind of a lame infomercial running always. Don't have to do that anymore. I play with my phone. I catch up on our, you know, comments to our videos. There's a lot of stuff you can do. So being punctual, in my book, it's still unbelievably important. In fact, I always tell my son, 5 minutes early is on time. On time
is late.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so.
I have some employees that need to learn that rule.
That's just me.
You just mentioned Facebook Marketplace. With the advent of websites like eBay, Craigslist, and Etsy, hawking your old stuff or self-made creations has never been easier. Before, you either set up shop in your garage or yard, hoping people would stop by, and you went around door-to-door selling crap.
Yeah. Don't have to do that anymore.
Nah. I buy everything online, but I'm not one of those people that likes interaction with people.
Yeah.
So
I've noticed that.
If I don't have to, I'll buy something on Amazon every day of the week.
Yeah.
And
that's this next one, is buying things is also easier. Not only selling, but buying. I just bought something the other day off eBay. I don't have Amazon Prime, so I have to pay for shipping. Mm. But eBay, a lot of the people on there ship for free. And so we bought a new remote, and it didn't have a cable that I wanted to have. And so I had to order a cable off eBay. It was $2.99. No big deal.
Wow.
$2.99 delivered.
Mm-hmm.
Who cares?
Yeah.
Internet rocks.
Well, it used to be that you had to check the newspaper or call specific theaters to inquire about what time movies were playing.
Nope.
Googling wasn't an option, and neither was MoviePass. I think the last movie I saw in a theater was Ben-Hur.
Oh, wow.
1962.
That's been a minute.
Yeah.
Yeah, movies have changed a little bit.
They have, and I'm still going to look at the newspaper to see what time
it is. You know what? The new theaters at Palladio,
yeah,
the seats recline. It's awesome. Awesome.
Wow. Revelation.
Yeah, it's awesome. All right, this next one. Now, I did this. Doesn't seem like that long ago, but it was a while ago. It's when you used to have to confer with a travel agent to plan your trips.
Oh, yeah. I remember that when I was a high school senior. We went to a trip.
Went to Hawaii.
Yeah.
They knew all the ins and outs. Man, they got you the greatest deal ever and blah, blah, blah. Now, just go online. I can get the same deal. Travel agents, I
think. Travelocity.
Travelocity. I think travel agent is the next dying. That's going to be the dodo bird of careers.
Yeah.
It's dying out. I lined up in fact, I had a lot of time on my hands, and I lined up a trip for Vicky and I and the kids to Hawaii a few years ago, and I was actually able to, by extending our stay a couple days, it got cheaper. Yes, because if you have a Saturday stayover, it seems that they reduce your hotel rate.
Hmm.
So just by messing with the number of days we were there, saved myself some cash.
Wow.
Who needs travel agent?
Yeah.
Sorry if you're a travel agent.
Yeah. Sorry if you're a mall worker, too. That's not long for this world.
No.
Remember, keeping in touch used to be that you'd have to write somebody a letter by hand. Now, it's pretty much... Facebook has enabled us to like distant relatives and friends' posts without having to thoughtfully engage with them one-on-one. Before social media, keeping in touch with people meant writing letters, calling someone on the, what is this word? Phone.
Telephone?
Oh, who does that?
That's crazy talk.
Or planning in-person visits with the people you missed and loved. Now you just FaceTime.
Yeah.
You know?
Yep.
Who would Ronnie think about that? Remember when we were kids, we used to see, like, in the future they would have ways that you could see somebody you were talking to on the phone. And
right.
We used to think, wow,
that's
how cool would that be?
That's never in our lifetime.
No way. That's just the technology behind that.
We're there.
And now...
It's not even a second thought anymore.
Sometimes I FaceTime with my grandson during the work day because I just kind of miss him.
Yep.
And I get my fill.
If my dog could work a phone...
Your dog would eat the phone.
If only they had thumbs. I think Buster could probably do it.
Yeah.
All right, this next one. And I have a little personal story on this one, too. Fan mail. So you send a letter to, you know, Tom Cruise or your sports hero. I'm very unlikely that they're even going to see it.
Right, their people will get it.
Maybe their people will get it, and they might filter some of them out to hand one off out of the... 1,000 that they get. Now you can direct message them, you can send them a tweet. And obviously I'm sure they get thousands, but I have to say that Jerry Rice, my son was, we're all 49er fans here, my son was a gigantic Jerry Rice fan, and sent him just a letter that said how much he appreciated his hard work during the season and in the off season, you know, that made him a better player. Not asking for anything. Jerry sent him two signed photographs and a little letter, a handwritten letter. That is something, and I'll never forget that.
Priceless.
I just never will forget that, that the guy went above and beyond what he had to do for a kid.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yep.
He was always a quality person, if you ask me.
Oh, very much so.
Remember the day when you wanted to hear new music, you had to wait for it on the radio?
Oh, dang.
Oh, my.
It was a long process.
Wow. I remember as a kid staying up all night listening to my 9-volt Radio Shack realistic radio and calling the radio station all night long to try to get my song played. And the disc jockey would always say, okay, we'll try to get that on for you.
Right.
You know what that means? It ain't never going to happen.
That's not yet. Go to bed.
Not in this lifetime. Spotify, SoundCloud, iTunes, and the like were not around to help you stream your favorite songs, or was YouTube for that matter.
Right.
You know, that's my musical choice. Yep. I use YouTube for all of my music that I play.
So there used to be, boy, it's not that long ago, there was a MP3 pirating site. I can't think of what it was called.
Oh, it was green.
It was BearShare or...
Oh, somebody will write it in the comments
yes,
below.
Yes, but I know that at colleges, and my kids were in college at the time, and I told them, hey, not a good idea. They sued several people for several $1,000s, and it was people that were downloading the music illegally and then selling it to other people.
Oh.
So they weren't particularly, if you were loading a couple songs for a mixtape or something, they probably weren't going to go after you. But if you were downloading music 24/7, they knew who you are and they were going to come after you.
Wow, yep. I do remember that.
Okay, so this one is amazing to me also. Remember back in the day where you had to use the damn phone book? So unbelievable. And then, if it was someone you plan to use in the future, you had to put, like in the little, your little personal phone book that had phone numbers, you could add them in there, alphabetical order, or if, say, if it's a service person, like, you know, your gardener or the person that's going to be putting in your air conditioner, you could add them in there. Now, it's all on your phone.
Yeah.
Every contact you have can go in your phone easily.
And if someone contacts you, you just take that information at that time.
Right, yeah.
And convert it to your contact list or whatever.
I have people that I meet. I had a work buddy that I haven't seen for a while. I saw him yesterday, and he just shot me his card. You can send your little personal card, and I give him my phone number. He shoots it to me, and then we're both set up, and I shot the back to him. Yep.
Yeah. Binging your favorite television show was not an option. You had to wait another week before the next episode came out.
Yeah.
Episodes aired when they aired. So if you made sure to park yourself in front of a television when your favorite show was on, you'd catch it. But otherwise, you'd have to wait for it to come up in reruns. And it would.
Yep.
Eventually. But nowadays, it's just instant.
Yep.
It's amazing to guys our age. Just amazing.
So my daughter told me I had to watch Game of Thrones.
Okay.
So HBO has a HBO On Demand. They had all 8 seasons on there. Typically, the first, I think, 7 seasons were 10 shows per season. I watched 2 shows a day. They were about an hour long each. I watched 2 shows a day, Monday through Friday. I watched the whole season in a week. And then I watched season 2 in 1 week. Then season 3 in 1 week. I felt like I got so much more of an experience. I didn't have that option when I watched Breaking Bad.
Mm-hmm.
And I did have to watch each show individually. And there are times when you're not 100% involved with the show.
Yeah.
You get sidetracked and then you miss something important.
Right.
So Game of Thrones, I feel like I got everything important out of the show I needed to get.
Well, let's wrap up, Ronnie.
Okay, this last one is one of my pet peeves. You got all your news from a newspaper.
Been years.
Yeah, I stopped my subscription to a physical newspaper probably 5 years ago. And even then, we were only getting it on Sundays just for the ads for Vicky and stuff.
Yeah, I remember those.
God dang, there's so many different outlets for news out there. You have to be careful, though, because there is a lot of fake content out there, or content that's not necessarily fake, but it's not necessarily 100% true. Back in the day, a reporter was very, very open, objective. They would give... their opinion wouldn't be part of the story.
Mm-hmm.
Now, opinions are part of every news story, unfortunately.
And every news story really is all about getting ratings, whether it's
right.
a newspaper or a television show, whatever the case may be. I can remember when I first got my start in radio, one of the things that I'd do was write comedy. And the source for that at the time were newspapers.
Yeah.
And I can remember getting off the air at like 10 o'clock in the morning. And on my way home, I would stop by this particular bookstore that had every single newspaper in the country. New York Times, the Daily News, papers from L.A., San Francisco, Chronicle, blah, blah, blah. And I would have to literally go through each newspaper, hand by hand, page by page, looking for jokes that I could write.
Yep.
And then when I found a newspaper article I wanted, I'd have to snip it out and put it in. And then when I would write the joke, it would be on a notepad. With a pencil, writing it out by hand. Are you kidding me?
How archaic.
That is so ridiculous now.
Yeah.
There are three words that a person needs to be familiar with. Copy and paste.
Yes. Yeah. Or even two words. Hey, Siri.
Ooh.
Oh. I'm just turned on.
Hey, Siri, can you give me the weather for Sacramento, California?
Currently clear and 77 degrees in Sacramento. Today's high will be 96 degrees and the low will be 71.
Oh, man. We're spoiled.
I know.
Thank you, Siri.
All right. Well, that's going to wrap up our episode today of things that were way harder before the internet.
Thank you, Al Gore.
Thank God. No comment. We don't want to get political.
Yeah.
Okay, so we hope you've enjoyed the show today. A little walk down, stroll down memory lane about how life was so much harder back then before technology.
It wasn't all that long ago.
I know. Things just, I mean, it's hard to wrap your head around these things.
If I can make just one little aside before we close. Okay, we said Google started, and I can't remember what year.
1994.
There was Ask Jeeves.
Oh, yeah.
There were several other little...
Search engines.
But Google is by far and away the... It owns that segment.
Ownage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, anyway.
Thanks to Google.
Yeah, thank you.
And thanks to YouTube. Otherwise, we'd be just two guys talking in a garage.
Right. Yeah. That would be kind of a little freaky.
We did that for 43 years.
Yeah.
And the last 2 years, we've been doing this instead. All right, I hope you enjoyed. If you did, give it a like. If you liked it, subscribe to the channel. Ronnie and I are on a mission to get 1,000 subscribers as quickly as we possibly can.
Yep.
And we cannot do it without your help. As much as we could try to subscribe 400 times,
right.
It's not going to work.
So I only have so many relatives.
Exactly. Well, you've got a lot of relatives.
Yeah.
I could change the number. You could sway it.
Not all of them like me, though.
Yeah, I can understand that. All right, I'm Lou Gallagher.
Corbett Ronnie.
We're out of here. We're better, so smart. See you.